What to teach in preschool? Yes, this is for you because you are a preschool teacher and you need to know what to teach to your students. Remember, you have an entire school year to teach, so take a deep breath and let's rock and roll. Let's say you have all these notes about teaching preschool. Too overwhelming. You've read ton of resources about teaching preschool. Very frustrating. You deserve to know exactly what to teach as a preschool teacher to be effective and successful. You want to feel like a superhero preschool teacher and ready to conquer the world. Well, ready to conquer your preschool journey. First, there's social and emotional development. This is a huge and very important component to any preschool program. You will spend a great deal of your time dealing with self-regulation and students controlling their actions and feelings, building positive relationships, the importance of play, feeling a sense of belongingness in the classroom community, understanding different feelings, and steps of conflict negotiation. Then there's language and literacy. Students will learn about communication through oral language development. Develop an interest in literacy, especially through read-alouds. Learn about the concepts of print through a print-rich classroom environment, daily news, read-alouds, and the like. Participate in phonological awareness activities to learn about syllables, rhyming, manipulating sounds in onsets and rhymes, and even blending sounds. Letter and word knowledge, which will begin with learning the names and sounds of the letters. And even emergent writing, but students must be given opportunities to write. Yes, preschoolers can write, and it may start off with scribbles and letter-like approximations, but that's just part of the developmental process. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, there will be lots of math activities. When I first started teaching math to preschoolers, I just despised it. Really, I did. But then I realized how important it is to always use engaging and interesting manipulatives, even movement, so that I could make teaching math fun. So your students will be learning about shapes, classification and sorting, creating patterns, numbers, lots of one-to-one correspondence activities and counting, math operations like addition and subtraction, but not specifically using the mathematical symbols at first, measurement using non-standard measuring tools like how many cubes or links long is a particular object, and problem solving, which can apply to all of the above areas. You can teach preschoolers how to be a scientist. They will study physical science, which is learning about the properties and characteristics and changes of non-living objects and materials. Students may explore water, movement of balls on different surfaces and inclines, and sound, light, and even magnets. And life science, which is learning about the properties, characteristics and changes of living objects, usually with an emphasis on animals and plants. And even earth science, which is learning about properties and characteristics of earth materials and objects, such as rocks and land, the oceans, weather, shadows, and even the sun. In all three areas of science, students will discover aspects and gain a greater knowledge of the natural world, learn about cause and effect, observe and investigate, and even learn how to document and communicate their scientific findings. Then there's health. Students need to be aware of personal safety, whether it be staying safe at home, safe in the classroom, and even stranger danger. Preschoolers should understand personal care routines, especially appropriate restroom procedures. Oftentimes, when students are eating breakfast and lunch at school, these are great opportunities for preschool teachers to discuss nutrition as it relates to healthy and unhealthy foods and even eating balanced meals. Lastly, with the cold and viruses that permeate our schools every year, students need to understand the differences between feeling sick and well and be able to communicate when feeling sick. Also, preschool students will learn about history and social science. In the area of sense and time, students will develop an awareness of past and future events and relate them to present events. With regards to a sense of place, preschoolers will discover characteristics of physical environments. Preschoolers will display responsible conduct as a group member as they learn how to behave in fair and socially acceptable manners. In the area of conflict negotiation, students will understand the needs of fellow classmates, consider alternatives when problems arise, and negotiate constructively in conflict situations. Lastly, in ecology, teachers will help their students develop an awareness for the natural world and the human influence on it. This area is often discussed in depth around Earth Day in April. Visual and performing arts is an area that all kids love, and I think preschool teachers love teaching these areas too. In visual arts, preschoolers will develop artistic skills and express themselves with increasing creativity and complexity through 2D and 3D visual art. In dance, students will respond, express, and create through movement in dance and even learn about tempo, rhythm, and even qualities of movements like big and small movements, high and low movements, and smooth and jerky movements. In drama, preschoolers might portray characters in familiar stories using appropriate body movements, gestures, voice, and expressions. Lastly, in music, students will learn about musical sounds using their voice, body, or instruments, while at the same time learning about musical elements. The final area that you will explore with preschoolers is physical development. First, there's gross locomotor movement and manipulative skills. Think of gross locomotor movement skills as rolling, crawling, cruising, walking, running, galloping, and jumping. Then think of manipulative skills such as reaching, kicking, grasping, throwing, and catching. And fine motor skills, think of them as skills or any activity that requires students to use their hands for play and functional tasks such as when using Play-Doh, scissors, lacing string through buttonholes, fastening and zipping clothes, and even using a crayon, marker, or pencil. Thank you for joining me today. Please subscribe to my channel for fabulous future videos. Continue to add pizzazz to your preschool program.